Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Max.
Hello, everybody. This is Cecilia. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
今天呢，给大家送个超棒的福利，早安英文会员课程的七天免费体验权限，只有十个名额哦。同时呢，大家也可以加入早安英文的 Telegram 社群，来群里和我们一起交流。社群地址和七天会员的免费领取链接都放在评论区了，欢迎你来。
So, Max, you've been married for about a year, right? How's everything going?
Great. Brilliant.
Yeah, what was I thinking? You must feel like the happiest man in the world.
Yeah, I do. Married life is quite different from life before, though. I mean, more people get involved in your life. Not only my wife, but also her family.
没错哈。都说婚姻不只是两个人的事，而是两个家庭的事。所以说呢，不仅要经营好跟我们伴侣的关系，还要跟对方的家人处得好，这对一段婚姻的影响有时候呢是至关重要的。
Right. Fortunately, my parents-in-law and I really get along, so I don't have to worry about it too much.
Yeah, that's nice. It's really lucky to have understanding parents-in-law. 那除了你之外啊，还有这样一位幸运儿，就是美貌与话题度兼具的黄圣依。她呢也有一位非常智慧的婆婆。当然她自己在与婆婆的相处当中也是非常高明的。
Oh, I really would like to hear about this wisdom so I can apply it to my own family relations.
All right. 那这期节目呢，我们就来聊聊这种婆媳相处的智慧哈。From your experience, what do you think is the most important in this kind of relationship?
Well, I think it's all about mutual respect. As son-in-law, I must respect and admit their importance in the family.As parents-in-law, they are expected to understand and appreciate my position, to respect my marriage with their daughter.
是的，互相尊重啊，肯定是建立任何关系的一个最重要的前提。那就好像黄圣依和她的婆婆刘丽琴一样，老人家呢也是86岁高龄了哈，那在家里肯定是德高望重啊，而且呢骨子里多多少少还是比较传统的。
But she didn't let the conventional thinking of her day restrain her ideas, did she?
No, she didn't. When she was asked who did most housework at home, the first reaction was to say Huang Shengyi because she wanted people to praise her as a virtuous wife. 那老太太肯定不想别人说她媳妇儿不好，所以说，哎，家务活都是媳妇儿在干，那这样显得多贤惠啊。贤惠我们可以用 virtuous 这个词，那贤妻呢，我们就说 virtuous wife.
For example, I have a virtuous wife.
Yeah, I know. 一有机会就撒狗粮哈。那其实啊，贤妻良母的这套标准在现在越来越不适用了。那所以呢，老太太的孙女儿就赶紧提醒她说，哎呀，这样会被人说重男轻女的。那老太太马上就说，哎，都是杨三在干。杨三呢就是杨子哈，我和圣依就享受。
She is a quick learner.
学得很快哈。那这个 quick learner 就是用来形容这种学习能力很强的人。
Yeah, but from this we can see that she is not the kind of stubborn elder who believes it goes without saying that women should do all the housework.
Right, I couldn't be more opposed to this idea. 那刚刚 Max 用了一个结构叫做 it goes without saying. 它呢就是说某事是不言而喻的，不消得说。For example,It goes without saying that health is above wealth. 那其实还有一点也能看出这个婆婆是不是尊重儿媳妇的，就是看她对媳妇工作的态度。
Usually, once married into this kind of rich and powerful family, actresses will quit acting, willingly or unwillingly. We don't really know.
You got a point. It's the same situation that Huang Shengyi faces, but her mother-in-law didn't force her to quit.She just showed her concern about her health when she was stressed out by work.
Yeah, because as an actress, sometimes you have to work around the clock, and it can be so difficult.
是的，演员的工作性质有它的特殊性在啊。有的时候呢，剧组赶进度就是得通宵达旦的拍。那 around the clock 就是指夜以继日的。你看时针绕着钟走一圈，是不是就是一整天连轴转呀？那长期处在这种工作强度下呢，人就容易变得焦虑，焦虑不安的，我们可以用 stressed out 这个短语来形容。
Well, sometimes the generation gap is inevitable. But this way of communication can save confrontation and even bring them closer to each other.
对的，虽然两代人之间有代沟是不可避免的，但是只要双方表达方式到位了，是可以避免很多矛盾的。那这个代沟呢，我们就叫做 generation gap.
To bridge the generation gap, efforts from only one side isn't enough. Huang Xianyi must have done a lot to improve the relationships too.
Sure.She always makes sure that her mother-in-law feels she's being cared for and listened to. Like when Liu Liqing took a shower, Huang Shengyi would insist to stay by and help in case she fall down accidentally. Because it's really dangerous for an elder to fall at that age.
Yeah, exactly. Even if the mother-in-law was a little shy and embarrassed, I bet she must feel warm and deep inside.
对，她肯定是非常感动哈。而且啊，像黄圣依这种从来不做饭的，也会专门下厨，并且第一筷子就给婆婆夹菜。那好不好吃不重要啊，吃的就是这个心意嘛。
So when you imagine your married life in the future, do you conceive yourself as someone good with your parents-in-law?
幻想未来也不会幻想跟婆婆相处啊。不过呢，我觉得我应该还可以吧。I'm not a sweet talker, but I always try to stand in others' shoes.Sweet talker 就是指很会说话嘴很甜的人，那这种人呢一般就很讨喜，对不对？可是哎，我刚好就不是这种人，那怎么办呢？其实我觉得啊，为人处事将心比心比甜言蜜语来得更重要，对不对？那将心比心我们可以说 stand in one's shoes， 站在别人的鞋子里，其实就是设身处地的为别人考虑。
Right, but you know, some people could go too farthat they always obey humbly and never insist on their own opinion.
这个 humbly 可以指谦虚的，但是呢，在这儿是指低声下气的、卑微的。那尊敬不代表低三下四、无条件服从啊。就好像黄圣依在孩子教育和健康等一些问题上呢，她也会坚守自己的原则，同时去跟婆婆沟通。
All right. Well, I think I learned enough today.Hopefully, I will be as good with my parents-in-law as Huang Shengyi with hers.
那今天的节目就先到这里。
So, thanks for listening, everyone. This is Max.
This is Cecilia. See you next time. Bye.
今天的节目就到这里了。大家别忘了去评论区领取我们的福利，早安英文会员课程的七天免费试听名额，只有十个，先到先得。最后，大家如果想加入我们的听众群，也可以在评论区置顶找到我们的 Telegram 社群地址，欢迎你来玩。
This podcast is from Morning English.
学口语就来早安英文。